Good day, I'm your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker, and I'm just here with some more Let's Play this here Batman Arkham Asylum on that there PC. Right, stealth section, let's get in the fucking grate. As ever, the eternally important grate that we have to hide in. Frankly, must smell fucking foul in this particular area. You know, it's always a depressing thing when you start a new Let's Play video, and you can't for the life of you remember how exactly you got to this area, but you must have, because that's where the checkpoint saved. Ah, well. If I remember correctly, this is actually one of my personal favourite stealth sections, just because of how easy it is to hang these guys upside down. And as I believe I've mentioned before, hanging these guys upside down is possibly one of my favourite things to do in this game. Okay, so they're going to run across here, so let's drop down. Wait for someone to be dumb enough to run over here. You, my friend, don't be nervous.
Help me.
You know, this is just about the only time I'll accept that someone would have their fingerprints on the ground, because Harley Quinn does an awful lot of that there absurd cartwheeling around the place. I mean, she does do that a lot. She's mildly obsessed with cartwheels. See, her problem isn't that she's a psychotic bitch who thinks she's who dresses up a bit like a clown and thinks that the Joker is the nicest guy ever. No, her problem is that she's obsessed with cartwheels. Just gonna... Okay, don't mind me, but I am just gonna quickly grapple my way out of here. Oh. I think we've got a possible grab zone. Come on, bit closer. I'm not doing it to you specifically, you just happen to be one of the people that I'm doing this to. I mean, do you even know the number of people I've had to knock out just, like, earlier today? Like, not even in this room. Like, just the sheer amount of times I've had to knock fuckers out in this fucking facility in general is getting quite fucking ludicrous right now. Then again, if, you know, you can't really make a game about Batman's normal day. You get it, because he's making an army of monsters. It's clever. It's good. Okay, right. Where's Harlequin been cartwheeling? It was up here, wasn't it? You know, this game is drives me mildly insane, and I'm fairly certain a lot of people probably noted this and been incredibly uppity and dickish about it. But these aren't gargoyles, because gargoyles are very specifically a typically part of kind of a water drainage system. Nah, those are grotesques.
You need to stop this now, before it goes too far.
Stop. But everyone's dying to see what I do next.
Let him go now.
Really? Okay, if you say so, Bat. Whoopsie!
No!
You really need to speed things up, Bats. At this rate, you'll never catch me!
Whenever I see these shotguns on the ground, I have flashbacks to, what is it? Flashbacks to... Viscera cleanup detail. Every single time. Okay, I'm getting the feeling. I can't just do what I've done other times and shut shit down by throwing a batarang, I imagine. Yep. There's wires in the ground. Gotta admit, it's quite impressive that Batman's cowl is able to, number one, has this feature built into it when, as far as I can tell, it's just, like, flat with eye holes. But number one, yeah, it's quite impressive it's got this feature built into it. It's also impressive that it manages to isolate specifically those three wires. And this one, this is just cruel. This is... How is that too small? Come on, there we go. Look, Bruce, it's your dead mama and papa. How does that make you feel, Brucey? How does that make you feel? For a second there, I thought I was getting the character wrong. For just a split second there, I was convinced that he's not called Bruce Wayne, that he's called Clark Wayne. I inexplicably, for literally, like, 5 seconds there, convinced myself Superman was Bruce Kent. Oh, dear. Don't mind me, I'm just going mad. You know, it's only just occurred to me, something that honestly probably should have occurred to me a long time ago. Okay, so, we've got Poison Ivy, who... It doesn't say exactly how long ago these were recorded, but it's kind of assumed that the Joker, Poison Ivy, Scarecrow, these are well-known characters in this universe at this point. They've been around the block a few times, as far as... That's always the feeling I've got these games, you know, these are known entities. So, let's assume the same for Zazz. So, they... Look at the serial killer, Victor Zazz, who specifically targets women. And they give him a female doctor. And they look at Poison Ivy, the woman who's got, like, literally a kind of supernatural mutant ability to fucking fuck with men's brains with pheromones and make them her fucking slaves. And they give that, her, a male doctor. I'm sorry, I'm starting to get the feeling that Arkham Asylum is actually the SCP Foundation and that all the doctors are fucking D-class personnel. Because they seem to be deliberately putting them in situations where they are just going to be completely and utterly fucked by the nature of the situation. I mean, seriously? Okay, this guy specifically targets women. Let's give him a new target and let's basically just give Ivy everything she needs to fucking escape. Sounds smart, doesn't it?
I'm not important. I can't help you. You're lucky the boss don't want you hurt too bad. Said something about you being the perfect bait. Don't get it. You're nothing special. Who's gonna save you?
Yeah. And just in case someone does decide to try, we're ready to wait.
But Batman will stop you. You know he will.
The bat. It's the
bat. Hi. You know, say perfect bait.
You fools don't stand a chance.
Yeah, they say perfect bait, but I didn't really know he was in here. I ended up here in by pure fucking happenstance. I wasn't informed. No one gave me any proof. Again, I think this is just another case of the Joker purposefully fucking over his own guys. Frankly, the fact he doesn't have just doesn't have all of them get in a car park and beat up Batman at once is probably... Yeah, no, not exactly a good sign, right? You know what, I will save you in a second once I get this that looks frankly deeply unpleasant off this wall. There it is. Of course, two gas canisters full of Joker gas. Yeah, good idea, blow something up next to him. Clever, love it, nice, good. Intelligent, best detective ever. Power to the generator ahead.
Thanks. Are you okay?
I'm fine. I eat punks like these for breakfast. What were they doing in here?
The ones that weren't hitting me went over there and started doing something to the power controls. I have no idea what they were doing.
Is it just me, or does it look like Batman's, like, stubble has gotten a bit more overt since the beginning of the game? And maybe I just never paid attention, but if that's the case, I think that's, it's gone a bit far with the wear and tear on Batman. I mean, let's be honest. You know, I shaved my head this morning. It's, like, now, what, 9 at night? And I shaved my head at, like, 3? I think that's roughly the amount of time Batman's been in here. My head isn't covered with stubble.
Pamela, just bring it and show it to you when I visit.
But it's me, Stephen. I get so lonely on my own. You wouldn't want me to be lonely, would you?
No, of course not. Keep it. Just don't let anyone see. Really. No.
You can trust me, Stephen. Thank you. Now give me a kiss.
I can't. People will see.
No one's watching. What's wrong with you? Don't you love me? Call me Ivy.
Of course I love you.
Yeah, the fact that they also have these on tape, kind of, and they didn't just immediately take this guy off of the poison ivy bit. Like, and the thing is, like, does this mean they had to take her out of her cell in order to interview her? Because I imagine the reason there was a horrible red mist inside that cell is because, like, it's sealed. So her pheromone shit can't get out. Why? And you can clearly talk to her through the glass. Why not just have interviews with her from outside of her cell? Because she's too dangerous to let out in a facility that seems to be mostly staffed by dudes. Again, fucking Arkham. Arkham Asylum. It's run by Madman. It's run by Madman. I'm wondering what all that shit is. I presume that's just power boxes. Hmm. So, I'm just wondering how... I'm just wondering, how does one... Is there a... Oh, there we go. I was just wondering how one gets in here. Where is it? Where is it? There it is! Oh, destroying things. I love it. Welcome to my humble abode. What cop? What cop? Okay, nope, there's nothing there. Just a really fucking bizarre set of graffiti. Quincy Sharp's Arkham. I love the detail on the fat rolls. It's a promotional image of himself and they put like, a shit ton of detail on the fat rolls. That's beautiful. It's great, I love it. That's right. Oh dear. Yes, but really accentuate the undulating rows of fat. That's clearly
the... Well, aren't you the persistent one? That's always one step ahead. It won't be long before I have an army of Titan monsters at my fingertips. Ooh, just imagine me being carried through the streets, stepping over the corpses of all those innocent citizens. It's going to be glorious. Oh, I can't wait.
You know, I swear to God, the Joker starts almost all of his plans without any intention of succeeding. That's got to be the case.
At last.
He's got to have basically started this whole thing with the intention of not winning. Because like, he sabotages himself so often. And you know, most of the time that's a character flaw, but when we're dealing with the Joker, that's kind of something you can forgive, because it does, in some readings of his character, make sense that he would deliberately sabotage himself just to fuck with Batman. Yeah, it sounds like the by the way, is that guy dead or is he unconscious? Are you dead? Oh, shit, he's just dead, okay. I mean, I know he was dropped into fucking electrified water, but you never know, he might have survived. Then again, he was in there for... Yeah, no, that guy was clearly fucking dead. That guy was just completely fucked. There's no question there. Seriously, they just need to hire some orphan kids to come through here with fucking dustpan, broom, mop, bucket. Clean these fucking vents. Oh, God. Falma fungus is growing in here. Skyrim joke, ladies and gentlemen. I also don't know how he's managed to get mud on his knees. I mean, yeah, he's been all over the place, but let's be honest, how much time has this guy spent outside? Not as much as he spent indoors. Nope, hello. Bang. Thank you. I get the feeling we're going back into one of those areas. Yep. Mm-hmm. Yep, yes we are. Oish. Oh god, and this Riddler thing. This Riddler thing was the bane of my goddamn existence in this game. I'm sorry. Oh, yeah, yeah. On the entrance. Is he doing that over the intercom? Sorry, I'm just trying to think. Sorry, that's why I went quiet there. I was just like trying to think of the logistics of where he must be for me to be hearing that underground. I don't think he's close enough for me to be able to hear him, because he doesn't seem like he's shouting, so he must be doing that over the intercom. Either that, or it's just a problem that the game never addressed. Like, yeah, they just decided, yeah, this would sound good, but we can't really explain why you'd be able to hear it, so we're just gonna pretend.
Answer him!
Please, stop.
Hi! Okay, right, you can calm down, and I'm just gonna quickly... There you go. That's a proper Broadway dancing girl kick, too. Is this where all the janitors went? It does seem where all the janitors went.
Are you okay?
Sorry, my English died.
Okay. They were gonna kill me. We were in the aviary hiding out, and they came in with Joker shooting up the place and loaded us into cages.
Are they still in there?
No, man. No one's come out since. You got to help them.
Stay here.
Okay, why exactly do... Okay, I can understand having, like, a garden area in an asylum. It's a bit weird in this asylum, given that this asylum is a goddamn fucking hellhole, but... But, seriously, an aviary? That's a bit of an odd choice, isn't it? A fucking aviary in here, really? You ain't serious right now. Whatever.
What? You found that one too? Preposterous.
If I remember correctly, Mad Dog was the name of the guy who killed Amadeus Arkham's wife. I may be wrong there. In fact, I'm fairly certain that that's the case, because, you know, Constance Arkham, DIY First Lady of Arkham, decapitated statue, Mad Dog. You know, that speaks for itself, really.
Where is Dr. Kellerman?
How should I know, Warden? It does seem careless of you to have lost him.
I have no time for your games, Miss Eisley. Tell me where you have him. We have security footage of you and him leaving your cell last night.
So?
Do I need to spell it out? We know you hypnotized him, or whatever it is you do. We know he took you somewhere. Conveniently, security cameras across the island were mysteriously covered by leaves and flowers at 3 a.m. Now tell me what he is.
I'm not saying a word unless you do exactly what I tell you to do.
Really? I mean, admittedly, they did send in Warden Sharp to talk to her that time. I mean, I know he's nominally male, but he is possibly the most sexless and dickless man in the entire Arkham series.
Someone! Get me out of this thing!
Listen, the bat is on the way. If you see him, send the annoying doctors to hell. That's the down one, right?
Yeah, they're going down.
Good. And remember, if you hear a collar go off, Batman's here.
Imagine how sheepish they'd feel if...
They're all wearing the security collars. I'll need to take out the operator first.
Oh, shit, wrong one. Imagine how sheepish they'd feel if they killed all of the scientists and it turns out...
Forget about my little alarm, man! Did you hear me? Drop the cage!
Oh, bugger.
Sorry, looks like you're...
The fact that they have that built into the Arkham...
Played you like a violin and cut your strings. Nighty-night, bats.
You know, the fact that they actually have that capability built into the aviary of Arkham Asylum just continues to prove how much of a goddamn fucking hellhole this place is. Like, not when it's being controlled by inmates, just in general. This place is fucking monstrous. And of course, they give the guy with the lobotomy charge of the doctors. Great.
Joker's men are all wearing the security colors. I'll need to take out the operator first.
Let's try here.
He doesn't stand a chance. Not a chance.
Oh, is this damp? Ooh. Thank God Batman has thick boots. Oh, hello. What we're gonna want to do is shimmy shimmy. Hi, don't mind me. Crouching tiger, hidden bat. I'm invisible. I'm at a slightly different elevation. You can't see me. If I'm at a different elevation, I don't exist. That's how Batman Arkham Asylum, Arkham City, Arkham Origins, and Dishonored function.
Once I'm stopped, I'm gonna do it.
That's terrifying. That is legit. Yeah, screenshot. That's genuinely terrifying. Yeah, so I just wanted, I want you to carve a screaming face into the wall. No other evidence of it being a wall for decoration. I just want one screaming face. Amadeus Arkham, odd motherfucker. Hi. Hi. How are you?
I've incapacitated the main threat, but the hostages are still in danger.
Yeah, because they could just shoot them. How? Oh, fucking hell. However. Nope, you stop that. You stop that now. Okay, fuck this. You know what? Just gonna knock both of you out. There you go. That works. Wasn't exactly the most elegant way to do it, but it worked. Like, seriously, they have man-sized bird cages here. And they even have a system to actually take people out of them, so this is clearly something that they do to inmates. Good God. And of course, there's...
Joker wanted the entrance to the Titan production plant guarded. I should pick up Harley's trail again so I can find it.
Of course, there's... Goddamn fucking beetles on the lock, of course there is. Again, I want to know which company it is that Joker had specifically manufactured with the exact same smiley faces. Where is it? Yep. There we go. There it is. Well, it's good to know that it's not only Batman who knows how to make perfect rock formation looking secret doors. In we go.
Well, look who's discovered our secret lab. Since you've made it this far, let me show you what I've cooked up.
ladies and gentlemen, I give you a massive example of comic book science. Come on, big boy. Come on, big guy. Come on. Yep. Chuck a guard. Jesus, narrowly avoided that one. Oh, fuck. See, the thing is, they're actually a bigger danger to each other than they are to me, which amuses me to no end. And again, that's a problem. Big guys, but idiots at the same time. Oof. Look at that! That hit his friend. That did not hit me. Come on. There you go. There's a good lad. Hit him again. Good man. Clever boy. Clever, ugly fucking monstrosity of a boy. Come on. Yep. Good boy. There you go. Into the wall. Thanking you. Oh, do you want to go as well? Oh, there you go. Actually, I think it's only fair. Let's beat you up and ride you. Yep. It's only fair, seeing as Chappy over here beat you up. Now you get to beat up Chappy. It's good to know that the Joker is entirely equal opportunities when it comes to his fucking monstrous mutant production program. You know, Ebony and Ivory living together in perfect harmony as giant fucking spine exposed fucking freaks of nature with clown makeup. Come on, one of you run it. Don't stand there looking like a fucking room. Not even doing anything to hurt me. He's just. have fun. Okay, physically impossible, but. Okay, so you. Actually contributed more to your friend's demise than I did there, I believe. And now you're gonna run yourself into walls until you die, let's be honest. I never realized that you can actually punch them when they and do damage to them when they're not in their kind of slightly dazed, dormant state. Whoop. Come on, big boy. There you go. Into the wall, have fun. Oh, dramatic. I wonder how you can destroy the tankers of the deeply unpleasant fluid, but not the relatively flimsy glass on what appears to be kind of a special holding area for specific plants.
Oracle. I've destroyed the Titan production facility. But Joker escaped with enough to cause us real problems.
Just when you think it can't get any worse.
They've been using a venom plant hybrid to create the Titan strain. The plant's the key. And there's only one person on Arkham Island who can help us.
And what makes you think Poison Ivy will help you?
If her plants are at risk, she'll listen. I've a sample of her pheromone signature on record. She'll be somewhere in the gardens. I'll track her down.
It's a bit deus ex machina, that. Yes, I don't need an excuse to collect her pheromone trail. I already have it. But then again, let's be honest, he probably would, wouldn't he, Batman? You know, he is Batman and does fight her every other week. Right, so that's going to have to be all for me for now. I've been your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. So, I hope you enjoyed watching that video as much as I enjoyed making it. Let's be honest, I'm not kidding anyone, I don't know if I enjoyed it, I'm a pre-recorded message. Regardless, if you did enjoy it, please like the video, subscribe to my channel, and leave a comment below. I do read every comment I get, I need some form of validation for spending as much time as I do making these fucking things. If you want to see more of my stuff, please have a look around my channel, I've been making videos for years now, so there is a lot of content to see. I also try to upload once a day, 5 days a week, often with some side stuff going on over the weekend, so you may want to check that out. If you wish, you can follow me on Twitter, where I've been known to post inane bullshit on a semi-regular basis, and if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always subscribe to my Patreon campaign. Every subscriber on there brings me closer to not having to get off my fat ass and get a real job. And I'll eventually be able to upgrade my PC and all that shit. Well, that's it for this pre-recording. Hope to see you all in the next video. Now, get the fuck out. This one's over. Leave. Now. Now.